If you've ever tried building a website, you know the hardest part these days isn't usually coming up with the content. It's figuring out which of the many tools out there actually fits the way you like to work. Hi, I'm Garrick, and today, in partnership with Hostinger, I want to look at two of their AI-powered website builders that make it easy to quickly build and launch your site from scratch in minutes with no coding required, no extra plugins, and no third-party tools. Everything you need is in one place. We're going to look at their website builder, which is great if you like to start with a template that you can quickly drop your content into to build out your site. And we're also going to look at the Horizons tool, which lets you build out your site completely conversationally, where you literally just describe the site you want, and the Horizon AI builds and reshapes everything for you through chatting with it. By the end of this video, you'll know enough about both tools to pick the one that works best for any project or business idea you need to build a website for. If you want to follow along with me, point your browser at hostinger.com/AI website to check out and select a hosting plan. You can see they have plans starting at just $195 a month, but I suggest starting with the Growth Plus AI plan for a little more, since it lets you build and manage up to 50 websites, including e-commerce tools if you need to sell anything on your site, and it comes with extra AI credits so you can use the built-in AI tools. And all the plans come with hosting, domain, and professional email all included. Now, if you do decide to sign up, use the code AIWebsite for an extra discount. And they also offer a 30-day money-back guarantee so you can try everything out to see if it fits your working style. Okay, so I've gone through the sign-up process, and here at my Hostinger dashboard, I'm going to go to Websites, where I can see my different hosting plans, and here's my new one where I'll click Setup. It then asks you a couple of questions to help you figure out which tool will work best for what you're trying to build. So I'll say this website is for myself or my business. And I want to create a website, not migrate or hire someone else. All right, so here we can choose the platform we want to use to build our site. And again, we have the choice of Hostinger Horizons or Hostinger Website Builder. Both of them include AI tools to help you build your site. For this example, let's start by looking at Website Builder. Next, it'll ask you what domain you want to use for your website. Now, because I'm just creating an example website here, I'm not going to bother with this part. I'll just choose Use Temporary Domain. You can also use this option if you just want to start building your website while you're working on securing your domain name. All right, and now we see the screen where we have a couple of options on how we want to get started with the Website Builder tool. Obviously, they're emphasizing using the AI tool here to start you off, but let's first click Pre-made Templates down here. So you can see here we have a wide selection of categories for different templates you can use for your site. In fact, there are over 170 templates to choose from, and they're all customizable down to each section and block, and they're all mobile responsive, meaning they look and work great on both desktop and mobile devices. To narrow down the selection, you can pick a category up here. For example, I'll select restaurants to browse through those templates. And if you find one that looks like it might work, just roll over it and click preview to check it out. And then you can scroll through and check the pages out and check the links to see how everything is laid out. You can toggle between the desktop and mobile versions of the website very easily up here. And again, every site you build with Hostinger is automatically mobile responsive. But basically, all the text and images you see here are placeholders that you can swap out with your own text and images, and you can further customize the look of each page as well. If this template works for you, you can click Start Building. Or if you want to check out the other templates, just click All Templates to go back. Now, the thing about using templates is that you have to replace practically all the placeholder information with your own content. And not everything in the template is always going to work for everything you may want to include in your site. So here I'm going to click Try AI Website Builder to go back to this screen. And this allows us to use a prompt to describe the website we want to create. The website builder will still use versions of the templates we just saw, but you'll be a lot further along once it generates your site for you than you'd be if you just used a template from scratch. And all you really have to do here is answer two basic questions. What's your brand name, and what do you do? So for example, let's say I'm building a website for my bistro called Downtown Chow. I'll enter that as the brand name. Next, you want to describe what your project or brand is so the AI can figure out how to best build and structure your site. So I'll start typing in a description of my business. We're a small metropolitan bistro specializing in modern cuisine. Notice as you type, the builder shows you how complete your description is. The more you describe your business, the better the starting site will be. So I'm going to add one more sentence. We focus on fresh, seasonal ingredients and a relaxed neighborhood atmosphere. Again, you might want to be even more descriptive with your initial prompt, but let's start with something pretty basic like this and see what we get when we click Create a Website. Okay, and after just a few seconds, here's the initial version of our site that the website builder AI has produced. We can scroll down and take a look. And again, all the text and images here are placeholders, but this is already a lot closer to what I had in mind than what I got by just selecting a template. We can click the menu bar here to check out the different pages. So you can see it's built these four different pages for us. Over here on the right, you can select from different site colors. Now, you always have the option to click Create Again here in the upper left-hand corner if this isn't quite the look you're going for. But if you're happy with the site to start, you can click Continue. And that takes us into the website builder interface, and this is where you can start fully customizing your website. Notice as you roll your mouse over each section, you get this menu so you can edit the section. So for example, maybe I don't want to use this video as the top image for my homepage. I can click Edit Section and choose to replace it with a still image that I have saved on my computer by clicking Replace Image. Or I can close the section and instead click Generate Image to have the AI create an image for me based on a description. A hand-rolled sushi roll laid out on a rustic wooden board. Again, below that field, you can see that it rates your description. I'm going to leave it as is and see what we get when I click Create Images. And there we are. So I have two choices for my new header image. I'll just select this one. And there it is. Now, the purpose of this video is to compare the Hostinger AI website building tools, so I'm not going to get into all the details of how to edit websites in the website builder here, but just to give you a quick overview, in addition to editing each section of the site the AI generated, you'll also notice that there's an Add Section button at the bottom of each section, and clicking that lets you add a wide array of other common website sections like product categories, customer testimonials, photo galleries, and so on. And each of these sections is fully customizable as well. Over here in the left panel, we have the Elements button that allows you to add common page elements like additional text blocks, buttons, embedded video, and the like. The Pages section is where you can rearrange the order of your pages. Notice that dragging pages up and down changes their order in the navigation bar. And you can add more pages from here as well. The Style section is where you can change the look and feel of the text, buttons, and animations throughout the site. And you also have access to all the tools found under AI Tools for having the AI help you with things like generating images, generating whole sections or pages, writing product details, and so on. So for example, if you don't yet have a logo for your brand, you could try using the image generator to come up with one. And there are tons of more tools that help you start an online store, optimize your site for SEO, and all the options you see here in the More menu. So for example, if you're running a business, you have the option to add e-commerce with 0% transaction fees, and later use the analytics tools to track your traffic and sales. But as you just saw, a lot of the initial work was already done with that simple prompt we started with, and the rest is just plugging in your own details. And when you're ready to launch your site, all you have to do is come up here and click Go Live to publish it with a single click. After a moment, I get the message that my website was updated, and I can click View Site. And here's my site live on the internet. Now, if I were doing this for real, I would have connected a real site domain name through Hostinger, but again, this is just a sample site, so I'm not concerned about that right now. But that's how easy and quick it can be to generate, customize, and publish a site with just a simple AI prompt to start you off. So as we just saw, Website Builder gives you a head start with structure and layout, but if you'd rather not worry about layouts at all, and you want the AI to think through the structure for you, that's where Horizons is really different. So let's go back to our dashboard now and check out Hostinger's Horizon tool, which lets you build and customize your website entirely through conversational chat. So I've come back here to my Hostinger dashboard, and we're going to check out the Horizon tool by clicking Add Website. That gives me the options of Hostinger Horizons, WordPress, Hostinger Website Builder, which we just used, or if you prefer to code your sites by hand, you can choose custom PHP HTML website. In this case, though, we're going to select Hostinger Horizons. So, like with the website builder, we can again see an area to enter a prompt for the AI, and down below you can also start by choosing a template, like with website builder. But where we're going to see the main difference between Horizons and website builder is after our initial site is built. So let's start in the prompt area. You can type a prompt in here, and notice we have the option to upload an image as well, if you want the AI to base your site design on a screenshot or even a sketch that you upload. In this case, though, let's go with a text-based prompt again just to see what we get. Once again, you want to be as descriptive as possible with your initial prompt to help the AI get as close to what you want from the start. I'll try something similar to the prompt we used with Website Builder, but I'll add a little more to it. So we'll start with, we're a small metropolitan bistro specializing in modern cuisine. We focus on fresh, seasonal ingredients and a relaxed neighborhood atmosphere. Then I'll tell it, create a website with cozy fall colors. It should appeal to locals looking for a comfortable date night spot. And let's see what happens when we send that prompt. So here on the right, we can see what the AI is doing and coding in the background. And on the left is the chat area where you can continue to talk to the AI. Now in this case, before it actually builds the site, it's asking me a couple of clarifying questions. It's saying, what sections would you like on your website? For example, the home hero section, menu, about us, and so on. And do you want customers to be able to make reservations directly through the website or just display your contact info? So I'll answer those questions. I'll say, create home, menu, about us, and contact. And no reservations will be made through the site. Now, I am also free to change my mind about these replies later once I see the site it generates. I'm not locking myself into anything here. So we'll send that prompt. And the AI tells me that it's going to start building my site based on my specifications from the prompts. All right, and there is our site. We've got our home image up top here, the menu section with a couple of placeholders for the different menu items, the About Us section, and the Contact section. Notice the AI has followed up by giving us a summary of what it's done, and it's also making some suggestions on other alterations it can make. So at this point, you want to take some time to browse through everything, and then you can request changes just by asking the AI. For example, maybe I think the site is a little too bright. So I'll come down here and type in a prompt. The site feels a little too bright to me. Can you try a slightly darker palette while maintaining the fall theme? Maybe try some reds and yellows. And let's see what it gives me. And it tells me that it's adjusting the color palette now to create a richer, darker fall atmosphere. Now, as it's working, you'll see some tips over here on the right side, letting you know things like, for best results, be specific about the changes you want to make. So avoid things like, I don't like this, or make it different. You can add images as a reference for your design or a feature idea. And you can just kind of scroll through these different tips while it's working. This one I think is particularly important, where it says, for the best results, keep your messages simple, short, and focus on one change at a time. Okay, now in this case, it's run into an error. But the nice thing here is I don't have to go through the code or do any checking myself. I can simply ask the AI to fix it. So we'll just run that again. You can see it's telling me what it's doing here on the left-hand side. And after a few seconds, it's now resolved that issue, and here's the new version of our site in darker colors. So again, these changes were made simply by me making that request as a prompt. So we could continue this way, conversing with the AI and requesting changes. For example, I could ask it to create a different home image, like the one I requested with the website builder interface earlier, by asking it to change this image to a close-up of a sushi roll on a rustic cutting board. But there are definitely going to be some places on your site where it will be more efficient to manually replace or drop in content. But that's easy to do here as well. Just come up here and click Edit Content. And now we see these dashed lines around all the different text areas and images. So you can click on any text block and just type in or paste your changes. Or click on any image, and you can choose to upload your own images from your computer. And if you are someone who likes to be able to get into the code of a website to manually make changes, you can switch to the code section. But I do advise against messing around in here unless you know how to code websites. Although, if you do accidentally change something, you can ask the AI to fix the code, but it's better to not have to do that in the first place. Let's switch back to the preview view. Now, unlike the website builder interface, where we saw buttons to add sections, we don't have that option here in Horizons. But you can still easily add new sections in the Horizons chat. So maybe I'm looking through the website here, and maybe underneath the menu section, I want to add another section. So I'll type in the chat, add a section called Featured Plates, where we can highlight two dishes by displaying photos and a short description, place it after the menu section. And we'll send that. And it's done, and let's scroll down past the menu section. And there's our new section, exactly as we requested it, complete with text and image placeholders. And of course, you could replace these with your own images and descriptions, or you can even type your descriptions into the chat and ask the AI to help you improve or refine them. So you truly can design your site in minutes just through a conversation. Now, the other thing I really like about designing a site this way is that you can even ask the AI what you're missing or how you might improve the site, so you don't have to think of everything yourself. What sections or information am I missing or might benefit the site to include? This is one of my favorite things to ask the AI because it makes it your design partner that can help you fill in gaps that you didn't think of. So now it suggested things like galleries or photos, hours and location, testimonials and reviews, events or special nights, or a team and chef story. So it just reminded me, oh, right, I didn't include our operating hours. So I'll tell it to add the info that we're open from 11 a.m. to 10 p.m. Wednesday through Saturday, and noon to 6 p.m. on Sundays. And you can see that it's now updated the contact section with the hours that I specified. Now, one thing I just noticed here is that I did specify that I didn't want it to make reservations available online. So I'll just quickly tell it to remove the Make a Reservation button. And now if we go down to Contact, we see that's been removed. So you could just continue this way building and modifying your site conversationally until you're happy with it. And once you're ready to publish, you just click the Publish button and your site will be online. And after that, you can come back to update it at any time, again, just by having a conversation with the Horizons AI. Okay, so that's a look at the two options for building websites with AI through Hostinger. Website Builder is best if you like starting from a clean, professional template and customizing, and Horizons is best if you want to describe what you want and let the AI build and reshape everything for you. You decide which style matches you, and both options are available with your Hostinger web hosting subscription. So remember, if you want to give them a try, be sure to use the address in the description and the coupon code for an extra discount. If you found this video useful, please give it a like, and be sure to subscribe to watch more videos like this one. So until next time, I'm Garrick, thanks for watching, and we'll see you soon.